Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to carve a face into a mountain. I provided this photo of a mountain that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Open a photo of a face that you'd like to use. Choose one that's mainly lit from one side so it casts shadows on the face. To automatically adjust its brightness and contrast, you could either press Ctrl or Command Shift L to invoke Auto Tone, or press Ctrl Alt L on Windows, or Command Option L on a Mac to invoke Auto Levels. Try both to see which one looks best to you. Remember, to undo your last step, press Ctrl or Command Z. If your photo is in color, press Ctrl or Command Shift U to desaturate it. We need to make a selection around the face so we can cut it out from its background. There are many ways to make selections, but for this example, I'll use the magnetic lasso tool. I generally like to use a relatively low width, low contrast, and high frequency. The width is the size of the area that Photoshop looks at to find edges. The contrast amount determines how much of a difference there must be in color or brightness value between the subject and its background for Photoshop to consider something as an edge. The frequency is the amount of anchor points Photoshop lays down along the edge. Start anywhere on the face and carefully drag your tool over the edge. The hair edges don't have to be perfect. If anchor points get added in the wrong spot, press the Delete key to remove them, and then continue along the edge. When you reach the first anchor point, you'll see a small ring. If you left-click on your mouse or pen, it'll close the path and instantly make the path into a selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut the face from its background and copy it to its own layer. To move it into the mountain document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the mountain. Without releasing your cursor, drag it down onto the image and release. To resize, position, and angle it, press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. The shadows on this face are pointing in the right direction. However, if the shadows on your subject are pointing in the opposite direction from the shadows on the mountain, go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Horizontal. To resize it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go to the inside of the transform and drag it to approximately this area. To angle it, go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. Continue to make adjustments and then press Enter or Return. Click off the eyeball next to the layer to temporarily hide it, and click the thumbnail of the mountain to make it active. We're going to make the mountain into a displacement map to make the face follow the contours of the mountain. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Duplicate Layer. Click New and type in Displacement. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Displacement maps look best when they're slightly blurred, so go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel and click OK. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop as a PSD file and click Save. If you see this warning, click OK. Then close the displacement file. Make a copy of the background by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change its blend mode to soft light. Drag the copy to the top of the Layers panel and click off its eyeball to temporarily hide it. Make the face visible and active. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Displace it 10 pixels, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Then click OK. Click the displacement file and click Open. The face is now wrapping itself around the contours of the mountain based on its luminance values. Make a copy of the face. Hide the copy and make the original active. Change its blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 40%. Make the face copy visible and active. Change its blend mode to multiply and double-click its thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay. Click the color box and type in 3C361D. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge. Click Drop Shadow. Make the distance 90 to 95 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.